Today is day 12 of my juice feast, and I feel great. Today I have off from work, so I was just hanging around my house, cleaning, but then I have to admit I did a little mistake. Because, as you know, my sister and I make chocolate for companies, and it's a part of our business. So today I was making a tray to sell, and I was curious about the measurements because it's a long story, but we got our measurements off, and we for some reason we cannot replicate this taste that we had in the beginning, and so we've been trying to replicate it, but it just hasn't been happening. And I remembered something that I did the first time I made it and tried it again today, and then I wanted to taste it to see if it was the same taste as before. But I actually didn't really have the urge to taste it. It wasn't like I like needed to, but I just really wanted to see if it was the same. So I just took a little taste, and actually I was quite surprised that I think it does taste like the original one that we made. So it's kind of ironic that I might have found the secret recipe when I'm juice feasting, and I can't really like really try it. But after that, I had to make two batches, so then I tasted the second batch as well, and I probably took a couple bigger bites than I needed to. So I probably had about 2 tablespoons of the raw chocolate batter before I put it in the fridge. So I guess it's not too bad. It's just cacao, which I haven't had any cacao on this feast. I don't recommend eating cacao on a juice feast or any sort of fasting. But I had a little bit, so then I had some cacao, I had some agave, which is in the chocolate, which I've had on the juice feast already. I don't think that's a big deal. But the thing that the other two ingredients that are in the chocolate that I had were the cacao butter and almond butter, and I'm a little bit worried that that's going to mess up my stomach because I haven't had anything fattening like that in over 12 days, so it might cause a little bit of acid reflux or heartburn, but we'll see. This sort of thing happened to me before when I was fasting. I did a fast for 20 days, and this is not a feast, this is a fast, and it was last November. And I finished my fast by making my sister a birthday cake. This is not something I would recommend. I made her a raw vegan chocolate birthday cake, but I had never actually tried the recipe before, so I really wanted to taste it to see how it tasted before I served it to her and all of our guests. And this is actually how I ended up breaking my fast, on a raw birthday cake made with like a ton of like almond nut pulp, and oh my gosh, it was so fattening and so delicious. But actually after that I was just downhill, because that was just not the right way to break a fast. So that's one reason why I'm doing this feast, because ever since that fast, my diet has kind of spiraled downward. I really feel like I'm kind of an all-or-nothing kind of person, so if I start something off, if I don't start something off well, then it's really hard for me to jump back on. I feel like I have to start all over again. So I really want this juice feast to be different. I want to do everything really well. I want to do it as perfectly as I can, and even though I don't think it's a good idea to eat a tablespoon of chocolate when you're juice feasting, I don't think that I ruined anything, and I think I'm going to be fine, but I just wanted to admit that I had done that, and I'll just watch my body and see how it responds. When I was fasting before, when this happened, I ended up eating some chocolate more than one time, which I don't plan on doing this time. And at that time, because I had been fasting for so long, it actually kept me awake for maybe 48 hours, and I had so much energy, and I was like in another world. I was super creative. I was creating, I was like writing poems, I was writing music, I was writing this book that Andy and I are writing now. And I just had so much energy and I couldn't sleep. But I wouldn't say that that's a good thing when you're fasting, so please don't do that. As far as the feast goes, it's different because I'm taking in so many calories from the juice, but I still don't think it's a good idea, but I'm curious to see how just that maybe 2 tablespoons of chocolate will affect my body. I am happy that it happened now in day 12. I really wouldn't want to do it any later in the feast, so now that the chocolate is made, I won't have to make it again for a long time, so this won't happen again. So, just wanted to share my little indiscretion with you and let you know that even though I have a raw food company and I'm trying to be 100% raw foodist, I'm not 100% perfect all the time, and I know my sister isn't either. And if you feel frustrated because you think everyone that you're looking to is 100% perfect, please remember that they're not as well, and they're always doing the best that they can in that moment, as you should be. And don't give yourself a hard time if you mess up, because you can't change it, and you can just go on and make a better choice the next time. And I've had so many ups and downs in this journey, but every time I feel that I'm getting stronger and my willpower is getting better, and I just realize how much I don't need that kind of experience anymore. I'm listening to my body more, so it's really a slow process, but you can do it if you keep going. And I think that's all I wanted to share with you now. It's raining here in Tokyo, kind of a dreary day, but I feel really good and just really lucky that I have a couple days off to spend at home and relax. So catch you later. Bye.